the stress.
Saying amen, cause I'm going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick, acting like they know me. Cause I'm going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click.
The best of the best take the field one more time. Hey, it's the coach. This is the NFL Pro Bowl on EA Sports. Coming up, the next-to-last game on the NFL calendar, just moments away. The AFC and NFC stars, they're ready. I'll check you again at halftime. But for the call of the Pro Bowl, let's hand it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. It's the National Football League, presented by EA Sports. Coming up, it's the penultimate game of the NFL calendar, AFC versus NFC in the NFL Pro Bowl game. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And Charles, it's the Pro Bowl. You never really know what to expect, so I guess I'll ask you, what do you expect?
Well, in recent years, it has turned into an absolute offensive explosion, hasn't it? Games in the 50s are not out of line. What you're hoping is that some of these great defenders have a chance to adjust and react and maybe narrow that down a little bit. But I will say, this game is tilted heavily towards the offense's advantage.
Ezekiel Elliott of the Cowboys. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that'll make it second and 12.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
On second down, Elliott. 7 yards on the carry, make it third and four coming up. From the gun on third down, Shaw. But he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And this results in six. Touchdown.
I have to believe that in a Pro Bowl situation, you know, we talk about these defensive backs during the season, that they're educated gamblers. They take the education out of it. They just go for the football here. Hey, try and make a big play. And if you get one, you really look terrific in this game.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And he's got it to make it 7-0 AFC. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Here's the NFC offense set to take over again. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Here's second and eight. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And a good tackle there right around the 30. Stops him short of the first down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game. But it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the AFC for their opening drive as we get a peek at the former Red Raider and 10th pick in the 2017 draft, Patrick Mahomes.
I know he's not showing it on the outside, but inside, he's got to be celebrating because think about all the quarterbacking we saw in the AFC this year. Five or six guys could have earned this honor. He got the nod, a real feather in his cap.
Mahomes going to pull it out and keep it himself. Complete. It's Johnson. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. That really sets him back. A loss of six.
When you lose that kind of yardage on a pass play, you often expect it to be a sack. But that wasn't the case there. They completed the pass. Probably would have been better off just dropping the football and making an incompletion as opposed to catching it and losing that kind of yardage.
First carry for Derrick Henry. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Got a man, it's Brown. And they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground at the 26. It'll be a gain of 12, but it will also lead to fourth down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice gain.
This will be fielded at the 17. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the NFC will take over first and 10. The offense for the NFC back out there. And things haven't started so well for this side. Two drives, two punts.
So now you've got to start looking not just at play calling, but which guy's going to step forward and say, okay, let's get this thing done? Because within that unit of 11, sometimes one guy can make a big-time play and break through the barrier.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And the result here, a pickup of eight, leaves him with two to go on second down. Off play action. Shaw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
What a nice read and play by the defensive tackle. Never bought the play action fake. Went right for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Operating from the gun, Shaw. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. From the gun, Shaw. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive.
Watch the whip.
Elliott. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run blocking abilities. And we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big game.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And this is caught at the 8. 12 more yards there and another first down. Now Elliott, and this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Joey Bosa with the tackle for loss. How about that pedigree in his family?
Yeah, some good pedigree. Tell us about it, Mr. Davis.
Dad played in the NFL, first-round draft pick. Uncle was a first-round draft pick. He's got a brother coming behind him, but Joey Bosa, guy plays really, really hard and plays all aspects on defense.
And it's caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it's third and goal. From the gun on third down, Shaw. And that's going to be caught. Touchdown NFC. Christian Kirk there to make the grab as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor in effect.
Hauschka with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it's finished off by an NFC touchdown. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The AFC offense making their way back out. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Mahomes now to throw. This will be caught by Brown. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Now they'll try to convert on third and 6 after the 4-yard completion. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And it's complete to Kelce. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Mahomes to his KC teammate Kelce for the AFC first.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
Mahomes now on first down. Well, the NFC pressure a little too much as they get home for the sack. Aaron Donald. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Draw play. This is Henry. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Aaron Donald coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it also brings up fourth.
Hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run-blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he'll kick it away for the second time. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The NFC offense heading back onto the field. Their passing game has certainly been buoyed by some unbelievable catches.
I love that word, because if you're the quarterback, if you're the guy throwing it, buoyed would be the word, wouldn't it? Because right now, I think his confidence level is so high. I just throw it out there. They will go get it. And we're seeing some fantastic catches and some great plays as a result.
Ready to begin their next drive here, the NFC offense. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
This quarterback now already at 100 yards passing in this first quarter. It's first and 10. This is Alia. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. Second down, it's Elliott. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. To throw on third down, Shaw finding Gabriel complete. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. A nice pickup of 10 means that this drive will stay on track.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
I used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
Throwing on first down, Shaw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2. 10th carry now for Elliott. Oh, that's just not fair, and now room to run. This will probably be the last play of the quarter. Get that quarterback and all costs. 7-7, our score after one. 7-7. Set hut. Double. On first and 10. Shaw, and that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Quick throw here caught by Gabriel. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And they'll be facing a third and 12.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
The numbers for the NFC on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third down and 12. Back to throw. Shaw, short throw to Dislew. And he does not get to the first down marker. As they stop him at the 19, they get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Field goal forthcoming for Steven Hauschka. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. And the 13-year man puts it through, and they take the lead here now at 10-7.
Well, no surprise there. Extremely reliable during the regular season. Bailed his team out time and again. Knocks another one through, this time in the Pro Bowl.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Back out is the AFC offense. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
No room to be had there on the first down run as he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan. Throwing on second down, Mahomes. Man open left side is Brown. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down. A first down carry for Henry. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. Second down. On second down, here's Henry. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
He dumps it off for Henry. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move.
And I know you can't really see it, but that play spells frustration with a capital F for the guys on defense. They covered everyone else, end up going to the running back out of the backfield, and he picks up a back-breaking first down.
They'll run on first down. It's Henry. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four. The last run got six, now second and four. Derrick Henry. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. The AFC thus far on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be third and six. Now Mahomes, and it's complete. Henry, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen, because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup for a first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. This is Henry. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
A small bit of adversity here on what's been a strong drive as they come up second and 12. They'll toss it to Henry. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. The second down play results in a loss of 2 yards. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Mahomes going to throw. Got a man. He finds Sanders. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. They'll try and run for it with Henry. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3. Second and goal from the 1. To throw, it's Mahomes. And that is caught for an AFC touchdown. Deontay Johnson there to make the grab. And the AFC has retaken the lead. So second and goal there from the 1. They go to the air.
And the perfect down to throw the football in this sequence. Second down is always kind of the, do they throw it, do they run it? They worked it out to perfection on that one by throwing it into the end zone.
Butker on for the PAT. And that makes it 14-10. So that one, a 13-play drive in total. And it ends with an AFC touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Ezekiel Elliott gets ready to go again here on offense as he shuffles onto the field. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming. Looking to throw, Shaw, and that's knocked away and incomplete. Not much going on this drive. Looks like they're going to have to punt it away, CD.
And right now, I know a lot of their fans are screaming for the OC to change things up, get away from what he's been calling. Sometimes you just need better execution of the plays that have been called.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the AFC will take over, first and 10. Derrick Henry trots back out there and gets ready to go. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
He doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back. And that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend. Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. Johnson was the intended receiver.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Here's the NFC offense set to take over again and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
A first down carry by Elliott. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far, hasn't been too successful.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Now Elliott, he takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run. The numbers for the NFC on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is 3rd and 8. Back to throw, Shaw. And that is incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is it allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Here's Johnny Hecker now as he's on to punt for the NFC. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This one angles out of bounds at a good spot in the coffin corner. And they're going to mark this out of the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And Mahomes is going to go down in the end zone, and that is going to be a safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt, and if the ball goes in the end zone, this never happens. So great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
And remember, following the safety, you give the football up as well. And they free kick it from the 20 now. He'll return it from the 6. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get him back into the ballgame or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy, create that spark.
Well, so far he has one touchdown, one interception. He'll be looking for that second touchdown now. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's Elliott. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Off the play fake. Shaw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Joe Schobert came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
The numbers for the NFC on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is third and 17. Short throw to Disley. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
Here's Johnny Hecker now. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
The sorry, coach.
Sorry, we get slap happy up here sometimes.
Let's go.
Patrick Mahomes and the AFC ready to go on offense. They've got the lead. He's a big reason why. Looking sharp so far.
And as we travel around the league, we see quarterbacks get it done in a variety of ways. But today's NFL does tell us one thing. If that guy doesn't play well, their team's not going to win. And right now he's got his team in the lead.
And now they'll look to extend that lead. That throw good for 4. It's second down. They'll come up 2nd and 6 now from the 24. Throwing again on 2nd down, but this time it's incomplete. So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Complete. The tight end, Kelce. Now the NFC going to call the first of their 3 timeouts. as he'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he's on to punt for the AFC. A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense for the NFC back out there. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. From the 21, it's second and 10. Here's Shaw, and he fires one incomplete. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. They'll run with Elliott, and he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. Now the AFC going to use the first of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Here's Johnny Hecker now. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The AFC offensive unit getting set to take over. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try to move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
Now the AFC going to take a timeout. It's their second. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Now here's Mahomes. He's going to let this one go deep. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there in trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Throwing is Mahomes on third. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the NFC going to take a timeout, their second, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And this is away, it's a high kick, and he got all of it. Officially, that'll be a 63-yard punt. Well done. The NFC offense heading back onto the field. Under a minute to play here in the half. Time for a late drive.
It makes sense when you think about it. Hey, try and get a field goal. Give yourself a lead going into the half. But if you're going to do this, you better have supreme trust in your quarterback. Supreme trust in the guy who's going to handle the football. Because if you turn it over here, not only do you go in down at the half, you've given the momentum squarely to your opponent.
The first down run for Elliott will net him about 5 yards. It's second down. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line.
Here we go. Here we go.
So we have hit halftime of the Pro Bowl with the AFC leading the NFC. As we'll send you across town to our studios here in Orlando and check in with the coach at our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get you caught up on what's going on around the NFL. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Let's go! Let's do it!
The AFC offense now set to start this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another first and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Kyle Van Noy. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. And here the pressure from the outside linebacking spot.
And normally when that happens and they're able to get home, that means other guys on his team helped him out a lot. That they occupied people to allow it to be no less than a one-on-one situation allows him to get home.
After the sack on first down, Mahomes, the Sanders has got it, complete.
Oh, yeah!
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. From the gun on third down, Mahomes. He's going deep for Brown. And unable to connect, incomplete. I'll give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he's on for the fifth time here today. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the 1 yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
Now the NFC heading out for their first drive of the second half. And they begin this drive in very precarious field position inside their own 5.
And remember, this is a defense that's already scored once in this game. So you've got to really take care and make sure that you're blocking these guys to try and wedge the ball out from the shadow of your own end zone.
The All-Pro Von Miller there on the tackle.
And give him a lot of credit there, but even more credit to the guys up front. In that situation, you know it's going to be a stacked defensive front. And to be able to gain that much yardage, that's a big win for the guys on offense.
Yeah, they were just about standing on their own goal line. So to get a few yards there, a great start. Now we'll see what second down brings. 8 yards there, getting them out of danger. It's a first down.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far. And you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They just had to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. So a little more space to operate now. First and 10 from right around the 12. A give to Elliott. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 11, he goes down. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
To throw on second down, Shaw. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Looking to throw. Shaw drops it underneath to Elliott. Nothing doing on that one, and it'll be fourth down.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes. And they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as they're forced to kick for the sixth time today. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Taking it about the 16. 12 yards on the return that time. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And we spotlight Derrick Henry now. And in the early going, the running game, as we see the numbers, it just wasn't on point. Well, now it's gotten more true to form.
And sometimes it takes a little while for an offensive line to get in sync, because early in the game, defenses throw different patterns at you, different formations, different sets, and you might not block them.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Aaron Donald able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
Like how they started the third quarter here. They forced a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. They'll run with Henry. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. I was pretty surprised there when they lined up to run it on second and long, but it worked out for him.
It certainly did, and that requires some confidence, some fortitude, and a little bit of hope, doesn't it? You hope you catch the defense just right and break off a big run to help yourself out on the next down.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he's on to punt for the AFC. A 47-yard punt, maybe a couple on the return. And the NFC will take over first and 10. Here's the NFC offense set to take over again. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys are tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. This is complete to Michael Thomas. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now this one complete on the slant route. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Operating from the gun, Shaw. And able to find Kirk, complete. And that's going to move the sticks again here as the tackle's made at the AFC's 38-yard line. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
This quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and 2. Second and 2. Open man, Taylor Gabriel. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line.
Let's go!
23 yards on the play. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
From the gun, Shaw. And that's going to be caught. Touchdown, NFC. Michael Thomas there to make the grab. And the NFC has once again taken the lead. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller, but they've retained their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. Here's Hauschka for the extra point. And the lead is up to 5. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it's finished off by an NFC touchdown. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This is fielded a couple yards deep. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. He's hoping to channel his first half play. They had the lead at halftime, was playing well. Flipped the script here in the third quarter a little bit.
I think he misses the peewee days, you know, when you just got the orange slice at halftime, right? And remember, weren't any real adjustments then, right? You weren't looking at some tape, right? You weren't looking at stuff off of the Surface tablets. You just went back out and played. Right now, maybe the adjustments have caught up to him.
Well, we'll see. Maybe he just needs a couple orange slices here for this drive. From the 29, Mahomes. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down. Throwing now is Mahomes. This is Johnson. He's got it. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Mahomes now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Got a man, it's Brown. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 12 more yards there and another 1st down. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. He's going to float this one deep into a double team, and it's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. They were looking for Johnson that time.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his 2nd interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
The offense for the NFC back out there. They had to go the length of the field last time out to get into the end zone. And with this starting field position, they're going to have to pretty much do it again.
And I think the thought process going into it is, hey, if you have to be methodical, go ahead and do that. But what you really want are a couple of big plays. Eat up chunks of yardage and cut down the number of times you have to snap the football.
And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down. Try to escape the shadow of their goalpost. That helped. 10 yards. 1st down.
I guess it's good we can't really read the mind of the defensive coordinator now, huh?
Had him pinned back there deep, give up that run. Can't be happy.
Yeah, whatever is in his mind right now, we probably couldn't say over the air.